Every year, 3 out of every 5 Filipinos die from non-communicable diseases or lifestyle diseases. The World Health Organization says increasing major risk behaviors such as smoking, unhealthy diets, lack of exercise, and excessive alcohol consumption are to blame for this modern-day epidemic. How do we protect ourselves against it? Well, we're now joined by the Department of Health consultant, Dr. Anthony Liachon, for more on this glowing health threat. Okay, it's an epidemic. We're actually calling it an epidemic, aren't we, Doc?
It is an epidemic because mm-hmm. it causes 63% of deaths. Mm-hmm. So basically, if you're going to have the global data, 57 million deaths, mm-hmm. 36 million deaths are actually accountable to the non-communicable or lifestyle diseases.
That's a shocking statistic there.
Right.
So it can be broken down to every time 10 Filipinos die, maybe about half or more than half of that, 6 people out of 10, have died because of diseases that they could have easily prevented by just changing their lifestyle. What are some of the diseases that fall under non-communicable diseases or lifestyle diseases?
Okay, there are 5 basic diseases. Mm-hmm. Cardiovasculars can be broken down into stroke mm-hmm. and heart attack. That's about 48%. Mm-hmm. Cancer, 21%. Mm-hmm. Chronic obstructive lung disease, either bronchitis or emphysema, mm-hmm. that's about 12%.
Okay.
And diabetes is 3%. Mm-hmm. Now, locally, you have 5% mortality annually, mm-hmm. right? So there are 500,000 deaths every year in the Philippines. Mm-hmm. 300,000 deaths are actually accountable, are accounted for by non-communicable diseases. So if you're going to mass it, let's say with the famous dengue fever, mm-hmm. 100,000 cases per year, Paolo, and only 1,000 deaths per year. So you can see the huge disparity.
Absolutely. I mean, we lose a lot of sleep over something like dengue. But actually, there's a silent killer out there. It's taking out a lot of people. Now, why do you think it is that this disease or non-communicable diseases and this problem has just sort of been under the radar and has just become this big killer among us?
Well, there are environment risk factors that we can control. Mm-hmm. Globalization, mm-hmm. urbanization, and of course, stress in the workplace,
right.
Poverty, mm-hmm. and of course, in low and middle income countries, you can have low education.
Mm-hmm.
Now, non-communicable diseases, Paolo, or lifestyle diseases are not exclusive right now to the affluent elderly.
Right.
It is a disease of poverty, and it attacks the young and the poor segment of the society.
That's interesting because, when you say people who are poor, poverty-stricken people, yet they seem to have enough to indulge or overindulge.
Right.
It's a great irony, isn't it?
Yeah, because the problem with affliction of the young and the poor, mm-hmm. particularly the poor segment of the society, is that they have less access to prevention and promotion. That's mm-hmm. number one.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, they have less access to treatment because they're poor.
Mm-hmm.
And the last one, which is a bigger issue, they don't have the money to finance themselves going into the hospitals or the clinic.
Mm-hmm.
So you have right now a problem because 70 to 80% of the population are below poverty line.
Mm-hmm.
So if the population, the young and the poor, the economic workforce of the country are affected,
mm-hmm.
then you have a crisis right now in the horizon, both on the health level, both on the economic level.
Mm-hmm.
So therefore, you need to save the young and the poor right now because they are the backbone of this nation
in
terms of working for the country.
Right. That's another big concern. I mean, when we talk about the situation, you tend to think in terms of how it affects you as a person, how it affects family and a larger part of your community. But you don't realize that when you take it a big enough, you look at it in a big enough picture sort of way, we're talking about how this epidemic will really take a toll on our healthcare system and ultimately our economy and ultimately our health as a nation. You know?
Yeah, Paolo, on an individual basis, let me touch on that because you touched on it. When you're sick, you're not productive. You cannot mm-hmm, go to work. Mm-hmm. You spend money for medications and for hospitalization.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So you have direct and indirect causes right now related to health. And of course, because of the kindergarten adage that health is wealth.
Yes.
Now, translate that to the bigger picture. A nation's health is a nation's wealth.
Right.
So therefore, if you have a sick population, then you have a sick nation as well. Mm-hmm. Because mm-hmm. The backbone of this nation is basically on the workforce, which is basically a healthy and educated population.
Right. Okay, so well, what would you say? Obviously, we've already named smoking, excessive drinking, mm-hmm. Lack of exercise. But what is it about our lifestyle that has placed us in this position?
Well, they say that lifestyle is a choice. Mm-hmm. But I tend to challenge that. When I was Googling about you, you talk about green environment. Mm. Okay. You can actually turn blue all your life. I've been lecturing for 20 years and nothing has changed in terms of non-communicable diseases.
Right.
You can shout all over EDSA and everything. Now, the people will only respond to what the environment can actually give you.
Mm-hmm.
Let me give you an example. Singapore. When you go to Singapore, you are suddenly transformed into a different person.
Right.
You will not smoke.
Right.
You will not chew gum.
Right.
You will not litter.
Mm-hmm.
You'll throw garbage. Mm-hmm. You will not spit. Then when you go back to your native country, the Philippines,
your attitude changes.
Right. You're the same dysfunctional Filipino.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And basically, if you go, let's say, to other countries like Korea and other countries, it's about, number one, I think
mm-hmm.
the basic reasons why we fail is number one is ignorance.
Mm-hmm.
So we educate a lot of people. Number two is ineptitude. Knowledge exists right now that smoking and obesity and lack of exercise are dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
But people would not comply to that particular, guidelines correctly.
Mm-hmm.
And the last one, I think, is that the environment that we're living right now may not be actually, I would say, conducive
right.
to good lifestyle. That's my theory.
Yeah, absolutely. So, I agree. We need more parks and we need bike lanes on the street.
right. So what I'm saying right now, if you need results and solution,
mm-hmm.
the first one is the 3L. That is the Department of Health. That's Secretary Ona's mandate right now.
Okay.
The first L is about learning.
Mm-hmm.
It's about transformative education from grade 1 to high school to the collegiate level. And teach about lifestyle,
mm-hmm.
right? Number two is about LGU-led, because leaders should actually take on this particular challenge of providing a good environment. Because even if you actually jog, and you cannot jog because there are no bikeways
mm-hmm.
or pedestrians,
right.
and it's not safe for doing exercises, what will happen?
Mm-hmm.
And the last one would be to promote right now food labeling.
Mm-hmm.
So we're actually working right now with the Food and Drug Administration in terms of putting in calories,
mm-hmm.
a traffic light system, just like in Great Britain.
Right.
Where you, let's say, salt, sugar, and of course your fiber.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's a red light, then there's a problem there in terms of, you know. So you need to inform the public
mm-hmm.
because the unsuspecting victims, like for those people who are not really aware that, you know, a French fries will actually give you 500 calories.
Right.
A burger can give you 400 calories
mm-hmm,
as opposed
mm-hmm.
to, let's say, fruit and vegetables.
Mm-hmm.
So we will also adopt the food plate that was launched by First Lady Michelle Obama.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, it's about putting in vegetable and fruits
mm-hmm.
and then grains on, mm-hmm. on one side and, of course, the source of protein.
Right.
The bigger issue is actually we're supporting the doctors. Syntax for alcohol and tobacco.
There's that also.
Right. Because the World Bank and even the President and even Secretary Buchabad is pushing this because the annual budget for health is about $42 billion.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you have the excise tax for cigarette, 2%, that will give you $60 billion. The expenditures related to smoking is a staggering 400 billion pesos. So therefore, 40 plus 60 will give you 100 billion,
mm-hmm.
enough for the universal health care. And enough, of course, to get the 400 billion savings for health promotions, hospitals, payments for the salaries of doctors and nurses.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, you do the math right now. So hopefully, it's a visionary. I'm thinking about the SONA that the president will support, let's say, food label and, of course, syntax.
Right.
And, of course, healthcare law that will actually create more parks and recreational facilities for our kids.
Right, true. I'm looking forward to that. Well, this is a daunting problem, and I guess we have to take it step by step. The very first step, I think, is the very first of the L's is learning. It's just get people aware, make people aware that there are things that we should be aware of. There are things that we can be doing and at least be taking the first steps to combat these non-communicable diseases. So we'd like to say thank you to Dr. Anthony Lechon for joining us this morning and, well, painting this scary picture. But, you know, a solution is in sight. So thanks for joining us this morning.
Pleasure, Paula.